everyone, and welcome back to another episode of Xenoblade Chronicles Definitive Edition. So today, the goal is to head up to Prison Island, and hopefully do everything that Prison Island, or that we rather need to do in Prison Island. For this episode, we gotta play as Shulk. Now, I would prefer to, actually, you know what, we can play as Melia until we reach the area where we need to play as Shulk. But yeah, Shulk is gonna be something that we're kind of forced to play as during this episode at some point. Mostly because of story stuff. And an ability that Shulk unlocks. Where the heck am I? Why is the camera being weird? It's right, here we go! Seriously made me walk up here to hit a button to unlock something else, really? This isn't even a boss enemy, it's just a regular enemy. What? Huh? I'm confused. I thought this was gonna be a boss monster, but I guess not. I guess this is just what we're doing at the moment. Okay, summon Aqua, release. Might not be a boss monster, but he certainly has the health of one. We got elemental burst, so we're gonna burst end. Release the bolt that we have. Summon copy of the bolt. Release. Just gonna keep going with everything we've got. Thankfully, he has an aggro back onto me, which is really good. Throw him and hit him with another flare damage over time. Ouchies. Guys, come on. Guys, come on. Hello? Why did you come over here? What are you trying to do? Are you trying to get me killed or something? The heck? Damn, this guy's really got a lot of health, huh? God, that's kind of annoying. Okay, hit him with another one of these. Maybe it's just the party I have going here. Ow! That move sucks. Alright, I have Aqua equipped. I didn't even realize that. Okay. Alrighty then, let's go. I believe we have to reach the top of the island. Again, I don't necessarily remember how much work is actually going to have to be put into this episode, because I honestly don't remember the first visit to Prison Island, like, at all.
Giant. So this is what was sealed away.
How long has it been, Emperor?
This is our first encounter.
It is not you that I speak to, but your blood. The blood that shackled me.
I see. Then I assume I do not need to tell you the reason I am here.
There is no need. I already know why you have come. Use it. That is the reason I am here.
Oh god, so what, we start all the way at the bottom, we have to climb all the way up to the top? Seems like it! That's gonna be fun. You see a lot of these ether enemies here. I'd like to fight the other things without having to deal with the ether enemies, because I'm not a fan of fighting these ether enemies. I can fight this guy if I really want to. That's exactly what I'm gonna do. What else aggro? Oh, we aggroed two of them. That's fantastic. That's just absolutely fantastic. Gonna put this one to sleep. Focus on the other one. Well, I guess not. I guess we're not putting him to sleep because they're just going to wake him right back up. Fantastic. These have a lot less health, though, it seems like. As you can see, I'm not in a good situation because of the fact that we're fighting two enemies. Oh, now we're fighting three. Melia's gonna have trouble here simply because of the fact that aggro is not a very good situation for us at the moment. Ooh, that's not good. What do you mean enemy reinforcements? Are you telling me there's another one, Melia? Yep, there is another one. Oh, this is not good. This is actually kind of bad. This is not a good situation whatsoever. Oh, I messed up there. Didn't mean to do that like that, but okay. Oh my god! Well, we just lost this. I feel like it's still not enough to kill him. Run! Just run. Jaws of Defeat. That's an achievement? I wish you could actually, like, when you get an achievement, like, hit, like, the minus button to check what the achievement actually was. Again, I say I don't remember this at all. I should have played through this game. Oh my god. Wants me to go to this. Okay, then. How far up did we just go? Seems a little bit far up. Again, I don't want to spend time fighting the ether things. I don't even know what to call them. All I know is that they're annoying to fight, and I don't like fighting them. The nebulas. The ether nebulas. That's what you can call them. This is not good. And the amount of ether arts we're about to use, we're probably gonna aggro that guy over there, which is not good. Okay. I think, is it that Bolt has like the fastest cooldown? I think, yeah, it does. Jesus. Your rifle is always getting hot, Sharla. I'm surprised we haven't aggroed the Ether Nebula over there. Oh god, I hate that move, dude. Wake up! We still won't die from it. Oh, well then, I guess we're fine. As you can see, as I've said multiple times, Summon Bolt deals a lot of damage. And when I say a lot, I mean a lot. No, if you put like... Of course, if you put stuff like increased bolt damage and electric damage, then it's absolutely insanity. Oh look, we're already at the top. Which is actually good because we're gonna be here for a while, because there's like a bunch of cutscenes, I think maybe one or two boss fights. I don't know. All I know is we're gonna be here for a while.
We must be outside the tower.
Oh yeah. This is it. Of life, and all things will will bow to you. Your power, the infinite. As you now know, the sword gives the wielder the power of foresight. And I myself once used that sword against the Meconis and defeated it.
You're telling us you beat the Meconis with that tiny thing?
Its appearance is merely an illusion. Its form morphs to conform to the will of its master. The power comes from within. But its power was feared by some. That is why the High Emptier imprisoned me here long ago.
That can't be true. Our forefathers would have had better reason.
You are what you are. Do you not believe your own eyes? Open your mind, new ruler of the High Entia. The Monago is the blade of the Bionis, the only force that can oppose the Meconis. As the wielder grows, so too does his ability to control all things. Yet there is still power trapped in the sword. The Monago is in shackles.
Shackles?
It is suppressed.
You mean...
Yes, it was this constraint that gave rise to Faced Mekon. Mekon which cannot be destroyed by the Monago. Young Shulk, I will not force you. I ask for nothing in return. It is your choice.
I will.
Thank you. Xander? Respond, Xander. I know you can hear me.
I sense thought waves.
Xander, how many more will you sacrifice?
Who are you to talk to me? How dare you? You know nothing.
I am here to talk, Xander.
Two deaths! Stop at once!
not over. The people of Bioris will never let you triumph.
Alright, and as you can see, the metal shackles have been released. Metal arts can now be leveled up to level 10. So of course, the first thing we really need to do here is swap to having Shulk in the party. And you know what? We are going to try and do this with this party. Arts is where we want to go. We want to go to level up, we want to go to Shulk's metal arts, and we want to level up these arts. So let's see. Let's give Buster a level, let's give Enchant a level, and that's all we can do for right now. But that should be enough to do this. And as you can tell, if you couldn't hear, the music playing at the moment is actually the unique enemy music. It isn't regular boss battle music, and I think that it is one of the coolest things that this game does sometimes. Is playing songs like that at just the right moments. So now this is just basically one heck of a fight. As you can see, he's level 42. We are one level above him. But if you still couldn't see, he still does have quite a bit of health, and he still does quite a bit of damage. You know what? It might have been a better idea to have Fiora here instead. But here we are. Oh, I got it off just in time, dude. Oh, boy, that could have been bad. And we've got our full party gauge, so let's go ahead and do it. Let's use Air Slash to inflict Break. Inflict Topple. Daze him. I'm surprised they didn't let me go more than that. And we can basically just keep him on the ground here if you really feel like it. Monado Buster! So as you can also see, the Monado now deals more damage as well. And I am not going to let this man breathe for a second. He wants to get right back up, but unfortunately for him, he's going right back down. Backslash! Let's do Gale Slash. Not going to allow this man to get back up. Okay, well, I think the fight's over here.
Change at all.
it is clear. But still, I cannot.
Do as you please.
Wait!
My mission is complete. Returning to base.
Too late. Again. I saw it. I knew it would happen.
Shulk.
Why? Why did this have to happen?
Father.
Melia, the hope of our people. You must not cry.
Don't say that. I don't care how improper it is. Let me cry.
Melia.
Why does it have to be me? All it takes is to be half-homed.
Is that what you think? You are very much mistaken.
But...
to become the home of the High Entia is a fate that you choose for yourself. As long as you remember this. It is certain that you will be worthy of that name. But remember this also. It is not because you are the hope of the High Entia that I love you. It is because I love you. I wish for you to become that hope. Heir to the Monado, I leave the sword in your hands. The sword that my forefathers sealed away. With it, you can succeed.
Your Majesty.
Melia. Cry for as long as you must. But when your tears are dry.
Well played indeed, Zanza.
I do what is necessary for the world.
I could very easily have stood in for you.
Your sentiment is appreciated. I see a storm on the horizon.
And finally, Crown Princess Melia's accession will take place 1 year from today. Until such time, as decreed by the Crown Princess, I shall assume imperial duties as regent. If there is anyone who objects to said decision, state your grievances now.
All the ministries are unanimous. We have no objection to Her Majesty's decree.
To each and every one of you, our thanks.
If I may, Your Highness, I would like to propose a roundtable discussion on strategy concerning the Mekon.
Ah, what to do about the Mekon? Our defenses must be shored up immediately.
Not only our defenses, Your Highness.
Do you suggest an offensive approach? While the capital still licks its wounds?
The Ministry of Research has the ideal solution.
Recognizes. She's not the Fiora I remember.
It looked a lot like Fiora. But if it was her, then I can't imagine how dumb that feels.
What did he mean?
Fiora is Dumbad's sister.
I didn't know. Is this Fiora important to Shulk?
Important? She's more than important. She's the reason we're out here. If that really was Fiora, why didn't you reply to me? I best talk to Dunbar. He'll know something.
Well, I wasn't expecting to get back into gameplay at this point at all. But anyway, here we are. So that is probably, in my opinion, one of the coolest freaking cutscenes in this game, and yet also one of the saddest and most emotional at the same time. That cutscene and Lost, the cutscene from chapter, what was it, 3? The one where Fiora supposedly dies, but as we can see, not necessarily the case. Those two cutscenes are, in my opinion, the best cutscenes in the game. That is if I'm not misremembering anything from the second half of the game at this point. But anyway, yeah, I also really, really like the look of the upgraded Monado. It just looks really cool, and now we have access to upgrade fully all of our Monado arts, which is actually really good. And also, I just want to say, the music that plays during the cutscene where we see Fiora is actually a song called Shulk and Fiora. It's kind of very similar to the main theme, or the title theme that you hear when you first open up the game. But knowing the name of the song, it foreshadows pretty well what's actually about to happen. Not to mention that it's kind of also sad and melancholy, but also hopeful at the same time.
Jealous that she had you as her brother.
Ah, yes. You and Fiora used to be inseparable.
Yeah.
I need to tell you something. I always thought if Fiora were to be with anyone, it should be you.
What? But Ryan hangs out with her just as much as me.
Yeah, he does. But Fiora doesn't like him in that way.
Oh. I see.
He's a nice guy. Reminds me of myself when I was his age. All reckless and hot-headed. Probably why he's not right for her. Listen, Shulk.
Yes?
A lost life can never be returned. But she's alive. It doesn't matter that she's lost her memory.
Yeah. I guess you're right.
Fiora and I have spent our entire lives together. The memory of that can't have disappeared completely. It's up to us. We have to help her remember. Help me, Shulk. Help me get her back.
You know I will.
Okay. Let's go tell the others.
Hey, they're back.
Have you gathered your thoughts?
Yes. Sorry to be a nuisance.
Shulk, you too?
Yep. All thanks to Dunban.
I'm glad.
Forgive me, His Highness Kallian summons you.
You think something's happened?
We won't know until we get there.
So, I really, really like how, even through all the sad moments this game has, the game is basically constantly telling you to be hopeful. I really, really like that about this game. Because while all the other Xenoblade games, at the end of the game, usually there's going to be some tears, mostly because of a sad ending or seemingly sad ending, and then they pull a gotcha! This game ends in a way that is a lot more happy, I would say. But this entire game really just, it's fantastic. There's no other way of saying it. The way that they built the story for this game is absolutely amazing. It's a fantastic narrative. Its themes are great. This game in general is fantastic. Of course, it can be a little bit difficult on your first time of a playthrough, but again, especially with Definitive Edition, the casual mode helps out a lot for people who are not super into JRPGs and everything. I would always say that this game is a game that should be recommended to people more often, because it's absolutely fantastic.
I apologize for calling you at short notice.
It's fine. Is anything wrong?
I must apologize to you all. Forgive our hubris. We High Entia were arrogant enough to idly sit behind our defenses, safe in the knowledge that Meconis lies a great distance from our land. We were wrong. Our decision to ignore the Mekon assault on your homeland was wrong.
Your Highness, does this mean...
Yes, Shulk. We will face the dangers ahead together.
Brother.
Which leads me to my request. After setting eyes on a group consisting of Homs, Nobon, and High Entia alike, I realized an allied army must be formed. I ask that you act as ambassadors for the assembly of this force. Tell me your thoughts, Shulk.
I need time before I make a decision.
Does Shulk not wish to aid us in our mission?
I do not believe that to be true.
Then why?
Shulk has other people to consider. That wasn't like you, Shulk.
I'm sorry.
You know you can talk to me.
It's the aura. That's why you hesitated.
Yeah.
Knew it. You wouldn't think twice otherwise.
I just don't know.
Find her, Shulk.
Melia,
I used to believe my father did not love me until the day he died. If you do not grasp the importance of loved ones until after they are gone, that is simply too late.
You're right, Melia. I've made up my mind. I'm going to get Fiora back.
You don't have to do this. I'll go and look for her myself. The burden should be mine.
No. I want her back as much as you.
Leave the ambassador stuff to me, Shulk. I'll probably make a mess of it. But we're a team. You can count on me.
I'm afraid that is my duty, Ryan. I am of both High Entia and Hom's blood. I am the Crown Princess, and of mixed heritage. Thus, I am best suited to carry out this task.
That means we won't.
Yes. I will remain here. We must say goodbye. Is that what you really want? Yes. But promise me, when you find her, you'll come back. I'll be here waiting for you.
I don't know what to say. Thank you. It's probably a good idea if I go and tell Kallion myself.
I am sure he already understands. Besides, it's likely that the ministers are harassing him at this present moment. We should spare him any further inconvenience.
Then, this is goodbye.
Yes. Come back as soon as you can. We are in great need of your help.
Got it.
Listen, I'll keep an eye on Shulk for you.
What do you mean?
It's a risky strategy, letting Shulk go off and just hoping he'll come back to you.
Shulk and I are merely...
Yeah, yeah. But remember, the longer he's away, the more chance his feelings for you will fade.
But...
Once we find this Fiora, I will personally whisk him back here in a heartbeat.
Don't give up.
I appreciate it. Great.
Don't worry, Melia. I'm on your side. Brother?
Just on your way out, I see.
It's not what...
I'm sorry, Your Highness. About your offer, we must humbly decline. I see. Very well. Let us hope my sister does not shed too many tears.
I stay because I must, brother.
There's two Melias.
I'm wrong. This Melia smell different.
Yes. We need Melia to learn more of the lands of Bionis. But she is still bound to handle public matters. Hence, another Melia.
Callion.
Your Highness, Crown Princess, as your humble subject, I formally request the following.
Speak.
I request that you accompany Shulk in his quest to find the Mekon that attacked Alchemoth.
Are you sure?
Shulk, I am aware of everything. Go forth and follow your heart. There will come a day when we need you. But it is not today.
Your Highness, that means a lot to me.
That is one cool prince.
If only someone had his sensitivity.
Sensitivity? I'm sensitive.
The jury's out on that one. That's a relief.
We have recently received a report that the silver-faced Mekon fled to Galahad Fortress, the Mekon stronghold in Sword Valley. It will be a treacherous path. My sister is in your hands.
Thank you, Callion. I will keep her safe.
Regent, I accept your request. I will return victorious with Shulk.
I am most pleased.
Leaving without me? Do you want to come?
To reach Galahad Fortress, you will need to travel through Valak Mountain on the right arm of the Bionis. The snow-covered mountains are fraught with danger. Those unfamiliar to them risk never coming back.
Of course, you would be familiar with that region.
Then there's no point in wasting time.
Leave the Allied force to me. I am not known for my diplomacy, but call it pride. I shall succeed.
We'll join you as soon as we can.
I look forward to the day. Heroes of Bionis, make us proud.
You see? Now I'm getting some respect.
We're back to this again, are we?
See you soon, Callion.
Okay, then. We only have a few minutes until the episode, or, like, until we're actually reaching the hour mark for the episode, which is usually when I like to leave it off. So I just want to take a quick look at the shop. It's 140 extra damage. It has an ether slot on it. I'll buy it. Could be better. Could be better. This is for Dunban. That's pretty good. We lose an agility gem though, but that damage extra, ugh. We lose a bit of physical defense, but... Okay, so let's equip what we just bought. That is Dunban with this new one. Okay. Okay. There we go. And that should be everything, I think. You know, that's actually a pretty cool looking weapon. I like the look of that. The, I wish I could see the whole handle on it. Hold on a minute. His arm is still kind of in the way. I don't know why, but the handle, or like half of what the handle, it kind of reminds me of, don't know why. Again, it kind of reminds me of Zack's, soldier sword from Final Fantasy VII Crisis Core. Anyway, here's something else in the skill tree. Okay, successfully completed quest award, more EXP. That's a good thing. Okay. What do we got here? Low tension. This man still does not have his inner peace. Let's put that there. Increased strength of the journey, reduces your cooldown during the day. Let's do that one. Here's your healing arts. Wait, can I equip this one? I can. Haha. No, he's unlocked one with Donban. Donban. Grants defensively vulnerable enemies. Okay, so we can do that one. Can't do anything here. I don't have enough affinity coins. I need 18. Charla. No. More defense. This man has literally nothing. Increases agility. HP received from healing arts. Nothing there. Restores HP to encourage ally. Allows medium weight equipment. Increases chance of double attack. Medium weight. HP. Restores HP to encourage. Increases chance of a chain link. Increases strength and durability. Reduces cooldown during the day. Do that. We don't want to put that. Alrighty then. So that was a little bit of setting up. We're going to end today's video here. Oh, God, I forgot the question of the day. Okay, so let's do a simple question of the day. Which version of the Monado do you prefer? The Monado 1 or the Monado 2? Which, yes, by the way, this is literally called the Monado 2. So which version of the Monado do you prefer? Monado 1 or Monado 2? Or rather, I guess the question would be, do you prefer the Monado 1 or the Monado 2? Anyways, thank you all for watching. Once again, thank you all for 200 subscribers. If you enjoyed the video, please share the video. Please like, comment, and subscribe. Make sure to slap the... Ow, I hit myself. Smack the heck out of that freaking bell icon and that like button. Ouch. And, I upload a new video every single day of the week at 5:30 p.m. EST. Thank you all for watching. And I'll see you all in the next episode of Xenoblade Chronicles Definitive Edition.